very cool. There's a few familiar faces in that video.
Thank you. Thank you, Jonathan, for introducing me, and thanks for having me today.
It's great to have you, and it's so weird to be so far from you like this.
Yeah, I'm glad I can hear you.
Yeah, at least I... It's quite noisy. That was a great video. We've had two of these government experiences, GX sessions, one here at the World Government Summit, and then the last time I saw you was in Berkeley in California, where I hosted you and several of your colleagues.
Yes.
And I wanted to also give you my personal congratulations on your huge promotion in this country, and
Thank you.
I wish you a lot of success.
Thank you. We have a mission to deliver, and it is all towards focusing on improving people's lives.
Yes, yes. That's what it's about. I don't think we need, we can never forget that, that all this work is about quality of life and improving people's lives.
Yes.
So let's jump into it. I have a few questions for you today.
Yes, please, go ahead.
So today is global governments battle the pandemic. The United Arab Emirates is working on creating unprecedented change. What is driving this unique approach?
To be frank with you, you know, the pandemic has been something new to everyone on this planet. Although the world has been through pandemics in the past, but in this time, it somehow shocked the system. However, you know, the vision and the leadership in the United Arab Emirates has pushed us to think of this as an opportunity rather than being a challenge. We really utilize this time to understand our resilience when it comes to delivering government services, and how can we shift our gears and be able to deliver services to people even when they cannot move as freely as they used to be. During this pandemic, we picked a lot of on the areas that we need to improve and develop for the future. Although we are digital, services are available on platforms online. However, there are a lot of aspects that needed to be addressed. And one of them was awareness of the customers, you know, on how to use government services online. Culture and knowledge of people has been for a very long time used to experience human support when receiving services, whether it is in government or private sector. We are now looking at how we can make these services easily available to the customers, easily understood by the customers, and delivered proactively without the need for the customers to understand or know about them, but they are delivered to their hand on their mobile without them even going to it.
Yeah, yeah. You know, I love you said you looked at this pandemic as an opportunity, not as a challenge. And it reminds me of how optimistic you are, and the whole society is here. Where do you think that optimism comes from? I mean, where does it come from for you?
Again, I go back to our leadership. His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid always reinforces us with his positive thoughts.
Yes.
And he encourages us to take the leap forward, to explore opportunities, and try to deflect any challenges away, and change them into opportunities, change them to success stories. And this is actually what is happening here in the UAE, as you can see today in this event. It's one of the first events globally where people come together. And this is a courageous step forward towards a beautiful and bright 2021.
Yes. Yeah, it's a great point. This entire event, it captures optimism and courage and leadership. It's a great thing.
Absolutely.
Now, I want to talk to you about this concept of proactive services, which is a term and an idea that you're coming up with and driving in your organization. What is it, and what do you see as the need?
Proactive services is something, I would say, that is unique to government. It's new to government. However, it has been deployed in private sector in the past. And the need for it is to make people's life easier, deliver service to them faster, and make the government run in the background rather in the foreground of the customers. What we mean by proactive services is that with the knowledge and the information that we have about our customers, we can deliver services to them before they actually ask for them. So we deliver services based on incidents or based on events of a person's life. We deliver them based on a time of the year, based on our data that we collect, and we know of the customer. If we use them intelligently, if we utilize machine learning, we utilize technology to understand the customers better, we can eventually deliver all of these services without the need for the customer to take any step or click any button.
Yeah.
And this is the intention that we're trying, this is our intention, and this is what, these are the steps that we have already started taking to shift government services to become proactive.
It's really quite incredible because I get the opportunity to work with governments all over the world, and they believe in reactive services, right?
Yes.
Like, what do we do when the problem happens? Let's react to the person's transaction. What you're suggesting is transformational. It's let's be proactive. Let's use things like AI and data to drive our insight and anticipate what the community member is needing. Now you have you've set up a whole group now focused on proactive services. Do you have some examples of recent output that the team has created?
Yes, we actually have developed bundles that go around the life of different personas of our customers. So, for example, we have a family bundle. We call it Usrati. This family bundle takes the family through a journey of easy government services.
Yes.
So it's triggered by the marriage of a couple, and then after that, all government services are just pushed to the customer. So they don't need to actually apply for any of the official documents or of the paperwork that is needed after they get married. So all of the work that they used to do in the past and the government centers that they need to visit and the paperwork that they need to submit, it's all removed, and they don't need to submit any documents, they don't need to sign any papers,
wow.
They don't need to do anything. All they need to do is get married, and then everything else is done for them. It goes all the way to childbirth, to even reserving school seats for the children, for their children ahead of time. So once the baby is born, his or her seat is reserved in kindergarten and in school for the future.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have other bundles also that looks at other personas, like, for example, investors and entrepreneurs.
Yeah.
So it's a bundle that helps entrepreneurs start a business. In the past, entrepreneurs needed to research and get information from different sources in order to be able to start a business.
Yes.
This bundle proactively delivers to them analysis and studies about the market in the UAE, gives them information about where to start their business. Is their business or the field they're trying to enter an attractive business or a field in this time, and where is it attractive? To help them make an informed decision when they enter this business. And then by a click of a button, they can start the process of licensing their business and starting their business within few minutes rather than days and weeks. This has come in through a lot of work that we have done with our customers. I would say we didn't design this ourselves. Our customers designed these bundles. They came and they sat. We had hundreds of customers sit around tables, discuss with us their needs, discuss with us how they would like the services to look like in the future. And this was a product of a joint effort between us and them. And then after this, we have pushed towards individual services that are not bundled to become proactive. So for example, we know that your driving license is expiring. why do you need to apply to renew it?
Yes, I wonder.
We will just ask you if you would like to renew it. Maybe you decide you don't want to drive anymore. That's up to you. But what we do now is we push a notification to you saying that your driving license is going to expire. Would you like to renew it? You just respond yes through a text message, and then everything is done automatically for you. And this happens with a lot of official documents, other services that are now transformed proactively.
Yes, yes. It's such a different way of thinking about it. I'm reminded, for example, when in the United States, we have to self-declare our taxation. We do it every year. We have up until April to do it. And, you know, fill out this complicated form of all my, you know, financial income and different aspects. The fact is, the government knows most of it already. So, you know, in really enlightened societies, they send the person the information and they ask, is it correct? To your point.
Yes, yes.
Now, you, at the very beginning, you said that this is all about quality of life and it's all about the person. So I want to get back to that. What do you think proactive services means to the community member, the individual? What kind of a experience does it have on that person?
Obviously, one thing to start with is it makes their life much easier that they get their services faster. And the second thing is that services are done on their behalf and they don't need to worry about them missing something official that they need to do because it's done on their behalf. This by itself would make their life easier, would make their concerns about what needs to be done easier. They will just focus on their life,
yeah,
their family, their focus. They'll focus on what matters most to them,
yeah,
rather than focus on completing certain official papers or official services, official government services. That will be done on their behalf. Forms will be automatically populated on their behalf. They don't need to submit official documents like their passports and the copy of their ID or their birth certificate or any of that because we already have it. Why do we need to request it once and twice and thrice, you know?
Yeah. Well, you know, it's one less thing to worry about, and I think that's a good thing. People don't necessarily wake up in the morning and say, I want to deal with government for the rest of the day. You know, they want it to be easy and seamless and almost invisible if it's done right. Now, as long as I've known you, and it's a little while, you've been pushing this a lot. I mean, your team now is leading in government experiences around the world. So what's next? What are you thinking about next?
See, the pandemic shed the light on a lot of things. And one of our main focuses now, the areas of focus, is to unify and consolidate. Customers tend to worry about where to get the services from. They need to download multiple applications. They need to go to different websites. They need to fill different forms. We're consolidating this. Our next step is to consolidate everything under one online platform. Deliver services through omni-channels. What do we mean by that? Is their experience will be the same whether they do it on the phone or they do it on the website or the mobile application. And they don't need to visit multiple websites. They don't need to download multiple applications. They get everything done in one window. And whatever is more important to them, whatever is relevant to them, will be pushed in front of them, rather than them looking at a list of hundreds of services that they don't know which one
right.
To start with. This is what we're focusing on right now. We're shifting from focusing on multiple high quality mobile applications to one super app with super quality, with super ease of use. And that's what we're focusing on now.
Really nice, really nice. So let's think further. So when we talk about vision, we talk about aspirational, we talk about, you know, several years in the future. What is your vision for government services in the United Arab Emirates?
See, five to seven years from now, my vision is that government services should be running completely in the background. Customers should never need to worry or think about government services. We believe that technology will enable us. to deliver services in a way that is unprecedented. And people will be communicating with a digital assistant that will be their assistant in receiving any government services, understanding more information about the government, about the country, about the city, whether the person is a citizen or a visitor or an investor or a resident in the country. They should be. They should all feel at home. They should all feel comfortable, and they should all feel that their only friend is this digital assistant that can help them with everything.
Yes. Yes. Great stuff. A very bold and visionary look at the future. So we've been. I've been talking about it a few times this morning, and we've been hearing a lot about GX, government experience, a term that you and your team coined. We've been hearing about it for some time. Could you elaborate on what GX is? What exactly is that?
GX is a term that came after we studied what is the most thing that's important to us when we design services. And in the past, the services have been designed individually and not looking at the entire experience of the customer to receive the service. We look at customer experience. We look at the time it takes to complete a service. However, we never looked at it as a holistic view from a customer point of view. Hence, the term GX, which comes from the term government experience. It's focusing on how customers experience government. And when we see how they experience it, it's even before they start to think about a service. How do they experience customers? How do they experience government?
Yes.
Do they know what they need to do? Do they have the knowledge? Are they aware? We start from the awareness instead of starting from the service starting point or a service touch point. We start from even when a customer is not using government services, they are still experiencing government. And this is where GX comes. GX focuses on government experience. It focuses on how customers live their life without the need to be concerned about government services, without the worry to on if they know the information right or not. We need to look at their experience holistically rather than individually for different entities or different services. And this is where government experience comes from.
I love it. I love it. And I'm very privileged to help in some way. We've been trying to work hard to evangelize this idea with governments all over the world over the last couple of years. And I know in 2021, we'll really put the amplifier on that, which is great. I have one last question for you. So I understand you've been proactively collaborating not only with other governments, but also with the private sector. What's your message to the innovative companies out there? How can they help you in carrying out your vision?
Obviously, collaboration is a very important part in designing services, in enabling a better future for humanity. And my message out to innovative companies in the private sector is don't hesitate to step in and be bold in the yeah. way you support in designing the next government experience. Today, a lot of private companies have a lot of technologies, have a lot of experiences that they have experimented with in the private sector. And a lot of it can actually make people's life easier. It can be applied in government, and having them step in, having them be part of the dialogue actively will actually enable us to accelerate this improvement and development of government services. And therefore, this is an open invitation for anyone out there, not only the big conglomerates, but also startups that have ideas on how to improve people's life. We'd welcome it, and we would open our space as a lab for them to test their technologies and their ideas.
Great, great. I hope the innovative companies out there hear that loud and clear, because you directly invited them to participate and help you achieve your vision. Before we part today, we're going to do one more video, I believe. So let's have a look at that video, and then we'll...
afterwards. Today, websites are created for the web. In the future, they will be created for you. Welcome to the future of government. In the near future, witness the most optimal user experience. Change the way you live, work, play. Manage your family's documents. Manage your health. Manage your transport. Manage your payments. In the mid-future, imagine artificial intelligence that understands you, feels you, empathizes with you.
Hello, Rashid. I'm Mira, your government advisor. How can I help you today?
That provides positive, free-flowing experience.
Hi, Mira. I would like to check on my health, please.
Hello, Rashid. I'm your virtual doctor. I checked your vitals and your blood sugar level is low. I suggest you consult your physician.
Welcome to the future of government, where it's all centered around you.
Very nice, very nice. Well, thank you. It's been such an honor to be with you again. Lovely to see you. Congratulations on all your success.
Thank you very much, Jonathan. I really appreciate your effort and time. And I don't think we can shake, but maybe bump fist.
Great to see you.
Thank you.